Deep in the forest of Albion lay the small town of Oakvale, unchanged by time and untouched by the sword. Here lived a boy and his family, a boy dreaming of greatness, of one day being a hero. Sometimes he imagined himself as a noble knight or a powerful wizard. And other times he dreamt he'd be an evil warrior. But in all his dreams of greatness, he could not possibly imagine the power of the destiny that lay before him.
Come on, wake up. Daydreaming again, were you? Just like your mother, mind always wandering. Well, let it wander off to find your sister, will you? She's out playing by the Barrowfields gate. Remember, you haven't given her a birthday present yet. Don't tell me you forgot to get her one. Well, I'm not bailing you out this time, son. I tell you what, I'll give you a gold piece for each good deed you do around Oakvale. That should be enough to buy her a present. Now, get moving and stay out of trouble.
Welcome everyone to my Let's Play of Fable, The Lost Chapters. Now, I have intended for this video to be as much walkthrough as it is Let's Play, and I won't lie, I have played this game multiple times before. So, I will explain what I'm doing and how to play the game whilst actually doing it. Wait, just let me change this back to Wast. Alright, we are in the starting town of Oakvale. The objective here is to find three gold pieces to use to buy a present for my sister, whose birthday this character seems to have conveniently forgotten. On the map, I don't know if you can see, but there are little green dots that represent places of importance.
You'll race yourself to an early grave, you will.
Oh yeah. Each one of those is something we need to check out. First one, are these two hiding behind you, hiding behind a house.
What? I've never even met this woman. Who is she?
Well, that sure sounded convincing.
Look, Sonny, keep your mouth shut about this, right? My wife's home with our little ones, and I'm supposed to be working.
Then why aren't you?
But a man should be entitled to do what he likes, don't you think?
Not in this day and age.
Tell you what, if you keep this little secret, I'll give you a gold piece.
Right, so we have a choice here. We can either take his gold piece, but get a bad deed, or not take his bribe, but get nothing. We're going to take his gold piece.
Good lad. Here, have this gold piece. My advice to you, don't get tied down to one woman. Look after yourself. Forget everyone else.
I committed my first evil deed. And I got a gold piece out of it. So, he said not to tell his wife, but we're going to go and tell her anyway.
Stock available!
Honestly, where's that filthy layabout husband of mine?
Behind the house up on the hill.
With some woman I don't doubt.
Not wrong there.
I run his house, bring up his children, and what do I get in return? Nothing. If you find him, let me know, won't you?
Tell the woman about her cheating husband.
Yes. You have? Right. I'm gonna turn him into balverine food. Thank you, young sir, for telling me.
I've committed a good deed. Ratting people out, people, is a good deed. So we're going to head up here up the hill to these two green dots. What appears to be a bully and a little kid.
Little idiots.
What do you want? I'm just dealing with this brat. He was irritating me, playing with my sister and a stupid teddy bear.
How could that possibly be irritating?
No, he won't give it to me, just because I said I'd rip its stupid head off.
Of course he won't give it to you. You said you'd rip its head off.
I told him, if he doesn't do what I say, I'm going to make his life a misery.
All right, let's see what the kid has to say.
Get him off me! Please help! He goes around the town beating up anyone smaller than him. But you look strong. I bet you could scare him off for good.
Oh, I can hit him and get a good deed. Hitting people and running people out is a good deed here. wonder if he's going to say it.
Have you cleaned my mum's car for me yet?
You hear that? Have you cleaned my mum's car for me yet?
I'm sorry. I'll leave him alone. Just please don't hit me again.
Thank you. You stopped him good. Thank you. Here, I'll let you look after Rosie. She'll be safe with you.
Hey, I just earned myself a teddy bear. And I got a good deed. Good deeds for beating people up. I love this game.
Oh, dear me! Oh, thank goodness! Listen, lad, could you do me a favour?
What did you have in mind?
I've got to, you know, answer a call of nature. Oh, stay here and watch this stock for me. There's a good lad. Just stand between those two stacks and don't move.
Wait, I'm going to get a gold piece for doing a good deed for doing absolutely nothing.
I'll put a good word in for you when I get back. Right, won't be long.
Does it bother anyone how easily trusting this guy is?
My cousin says that the barrels in these warehouses might have stuff in them. Quick, while he's away, smash his barrels up and see what's inside. Unless you're too scared. Unless you're just a big blubbing girl.
All right, kid, it would be stupid, but much braver, to do it while he is here. Beating his stuff up while he's not here is not... No, you're just too young to argue with. No.
Come on! Let's go and break stuff!
No.
Are you just gonna stand there like a lemon?
Yes, I am gonna stand there like a lemon.
But being good is so boring.
So?
Wouldn't you prefer to be smashing things?
I would.
Come on! There's still time before he gets back!
You wouldn't break his stuff if you got a gold piece for doing nothing.
No fun at all.
I don't care about being fun. I get a gold piece for doing absolutely nothing.
Fine. Have your stupid good deed then.
Oh look, here he comes.
Excellent. Thanks, lad. You've done me a big favour. I'll let your dad know what a splendid watchman you made.
And I did another good deed. Now, around here, this little kid here said that there'd be stuff in these warehouses. So, let's go and see what kind of stuff. These barrels are breakable. Uh-huh. I committed another bad deed. Nothing, nothing, and more nothing. Well, that was a waste of time. Nothing. Nothing. Ah! Beetle! Beetle! Kill it! Alright. Alright, I'll get to that in a bit. Ah! Another beetle! Kill! Nothing. And... hey, I've got a good piece! Ah! Beetle! Alright. That... is one heck of a beetle. Can just anyone else point this out to me? What kind of stock does this guy have? We break his stock and what do we get? Three beetles and one gold piece. Seriously, who ordered beetles? It could be an accident, but...
I've lost Rosie. Her stuffing needs changing today and I can't find her. Please help.
Rosie. That will be that teddy bear we picked up earlier.
She's a lovely little furry bear with a blue patch on her back.
Give the teddy to the girl. Yes.
You found Rosie! Thank you so much! Come on, Rosie. Let's change your stuffing.
Right. Now, I said you can get three gold pieces for to get the chocolates, but it is possible to double that. It is... to my knowledge, impossible to get more than six gold pieces.
He's an unpredictable chap, isn't he?
So let's go talk to Daddy. He'll give us four gold pieces, plus two, six.
I'm a man of my word, so here's the gold for your good deeds. But if you think that I'll turn a blind eye to your mischief, you're very wrong. Look, try to keep out of trouble, please, for me. Well, I think you may have enough there, son. Have you spoken to the trader?
Not yet, but I'm about to. Let's go.
Right, got you, you little ruffian.
Oh, no.
I've heard reports that you've been doing bad deeds.
What of it?
Destruction of a person's vendables. Accessory to improper man and lady behaviour.
If you beat the bear out of the little kid and give it to the bully, he adds, giving of a teddy bear to someone likely to rip off its head.
That sort of behaviour is not acceptable. If you were older, you'd be apprehended and fined by the town guards. You need to decide if behaving like that is worth it, my young friend. I'll leave it at that for now. But think about what I've said.
Uh-huh. Alright, now we have the 6 gold pieces. We can go...
There's something different about that boy.
We can go and buy the things from the...
Stock available!
Hello, I'm a trader. I wander the world buying and selling wares, especially to fine folk like your good self. Some little girl I saw said you have a sister, and it's her birthday. And it seems you haven't got her a present yet. It just so happens that I have a rather nice box of sweets here. Guaranteed to put a smile on any sister's face for only 3 gold pieces.
Would you like to buy the sweets for 3 gold coins?
Young sir, they are yours. Wish your sister a happy birthday from me now, won't you?
I got chocolates. And look, they're gift wrapped. Alright, now let's go deliver these to my sister.
Hello, little brother.
Hello, big sister.
I hope you haven't forgotten what day it is, like you did last year. I'm sorry if I woke you up last night. It was another of those dreams. I was standing in this field when something happened, but I can't remember what. Never mind that, though. I'm still waiting for my present.
Give the chocolates to my sister? Sure. So, we've established that he's a lazy bum, sleeps in a bit, and forgot her birthday.
I knew you were going to bring me chocolates. It's just like my dream. Come on, let's go home. Mother will be back for my party any minute now.
I love to party.
Wait, there's something wrong.
Bandits!
It's really happening. They're here. You've got to hide.
And so I'm going to hide behind the fence that they can see through.
One. Evil had come to Oakvale. Bandits wielding torches and steel, slaying and burning all in their path. Blood-red flames lit the night as the villagers screamed and begged for mercy, and soon their bodies filled the streets. Then the raiders reached the last house where the boy and his family lived. It was them they had slaughtered so many to find. The father fought to protect his kin, but he was no warrior, and fell mortally wounded. The bandits ripped the house apart, but could not find the boy. Through torture and threats, his mother and sister remained silent, and their furious attackers took them both. From the nearby woods, the boy watched as all he knew was taken away. His whole life was crushed to ashes. He was alone.
So bandits have attacked. We need to get to that gold marker on the map. Up this way, because the other way is blocked. Past all the dead bodies. And through this burning bridge. Sorry. Before I can see a body down there. No movement. No, that's... that's your dad. There's still one left.
We must leave. It's not safe here.
No shit, Sherlock.
They're all dead. You don't want to join them, do you? Then give me your hand.
Wait, if you could kill them so easily, why didn't you show up earlier?
Have a stronger stomach than that. Come on.
Look at that vomiting animation.
Save your energy, boy. It's not me you want to fight. You might not realize it, but I just saved your life. There's nothing left for you in Oakvale. And if you'd stayed, you'd be as dead as the rest of them. Come with me. My name is May. And I'm the head of the Guild of Heroes. You must have heard of it. You'll find nowhere safer in all of Albion, nor a better place to call your home. And if it's vengeance you want, you'll need the training only we can offer. Here we are. I'll introduce you to the Guildmaster. He'll be your guide from now on. I have a new student for you. Put him in the dorm upstairs, with the girl.
You don't look much like hero material to me, but Mays knows what he's doing, I suppose. Well, follow me then. You'll be sharing this room with Whisper, one of our brightest young pupils. She's playing in the woods right now. But you'll meet her in the morning. For now, you should get some sleep. Your training starts tomorrow.